UN member states will vote on Thursday on a motion rejecting U.S. recognition of Jerusalem as Israel's capital under strong pressure from U.S. President Donald Trump, who has threatened to cut funding to countries that back the measure. Details by Mahbubur Rahman.
The United Nations General Assembly is set to hold a special session on the recent decisions regarding the status of Jerusalem. Request for session was made by Arab and Muslim member states after the U.S. vetoed a United Nations Security Council resolution draft for the U.S. to renounce its declaration of Jerusalem as the Israeli capital. Ahead of the vote in the General Assembly, U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley sent a letter to several UN member states. In the tweet message, she warned that President Donald Trump had instructed her to take names of members who did not vote in line with the United States. The U.S. President Donald Trump has threatened to cut aid to countries that vote in favor of a draft UN resolution.
Today at the United Nations, for all of these nations that take our money and then they vote against us at the Security Council, or they vote against us potentially at the Assembly. They take hundreds of millions of dollars and even billions of dollars and then they vote against us. Well, we're watching those votes. Let them vote against us. We'll save a lot. We don't care.
But the intellectual said the U.S. threat would not take any effect on the voting. Swedish Ambassador Alf Skou said they voted in favor of UN Security Council resolution.
This case has been very clear. We've had the opportunity to express ourselves in the Security Council.
Turkish Foreign Minister Cavusoglu has also accused the United States of pressing other countries ahead of the UNGA emergency meeting. Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan said all nations should support for peace.
I believe that the international community will take a stance towards justice, fairness and peace.
Foreign Minister of Palestine Riyad al-Maliki accused the U.S. of threatening member countries ahead of vote and said American officials are committing another mistake. The Palestinian ambassador to the UN, Riyad Mansour, said he hoped there would be overwhelming support in the General Assembly for the resolution.
While unfortunately the United States of America, instead of being neutral to play an effective role between us and the Israelis, they decided to be more Israelis than the Israelis themselves. And that's why they selected to lose that status of being, you know, the moderator between us and the Israelis. And they are now completely in the side of Israel.
Mahbubur Rahman, Bangladesh Television.